driving, obviously, and I'm driving through a particular city on the north side of Indianapolis, which happens to have the most roundabouts of any city in the United States. So roundabouts. And this particular city is what we're going to be talking about today. So we're talking about the four reasons why there are so many roundabouts in this city. And at the end, I'll talk about a bonus reason as far as property value is concerned and how roundabouts might affect those. So stick around. As many of you know, Carmel, Indiana has the most roundabouts of any city in the country, which is amazing. And I'm driving through Carmel right now. I'm actually coming up to a roundabout, which I like. They're great. They're better than traffic signals for a lot of reasons. But Carmel has over 125 roundabouts, which is an amazing number for a city of Carmel's size. So why so many roundabouts? Well, there are really four big reasons why. And I'm going to talk about those reasons now. Reason number one is that they're safer. They're a lot safer than what you'd have with a traditional intersection with a stoplight. There's studies that show that accidents, fatal accidents, are reduced up to 90%. And any kind of accident with a serious injury, they're reduced 80%. And accidents are reduced 40% overall at a roundabout. And there are several reasons why. I'm actually at a roundabout right now. Number one is that you have to yield to the traffic in the roundabout. So that forces you to slow down. And when you come to a roundabout, compared to a traditional intersection, there are a lot fewer places to look. When you come up to a roundabout, you have to just look to your left. You don't have to worry about traffic that's coming directly at you. You don't have to worry about traffic that's coming from the right. And when you come to just a traditional intersection with a traffic signal, you kind of have to worry about all of that. I mean, traffic obviously is supposed to be obeying what the traffic signal is saying, but obviously people run red lights, or they'll make a left when they shouldn't be making one, or a right when they shouldn't be making one. And it's a lot harder to do that. It's not like you can't at a roundabout, but it's a lot harder to do something that you could mistakenly do at an intersection just with a traffic signal. Reason number two for roundabouts is that they're cheaper to install and maintain than a traditional traffic signal. It's estimated that on average, they're about $250,000 less to install and about $5,000 a year less to maintain. For a roundabout, I mean, to maintain it, all you really have to do is mow it if it has green space, maybe do some trimming from time to time if it has bushes or shrubbery or things like that. But just not a whole lot to do. Not a lot of electronics, of course, unless it has some lights, which some roundabouts do, but far less electronics than what you have at a traditional traffic signal, so it's not a big surprise that it'd be less to maintain per year. Plus, most of your traffic jams are eliminated. It's not like traffic can't back up at a roundabout, but it doesn't really do it like it does at a stoplight. And this is according to federal highway studies. It's estimated that you can save from idling cars, where you kind of prevent that in a roundabout, about 24,000 gallons of gas a year per roundabout. Now, if you multiply that by 125, which is at least what Carmel, Indiana has, that's about 3 million gallons of gas a year. And, you know, what does that come out to? We know gas isn't $2 a gallon, but let's say that it is $2 a gallon. That's about $6 million worth of gas being saved just from idling at the stoplights when you replace a stoplight with a roundabout. That's a pretty big savings for the general public. And of course, it's a little bit more than that, really, because gas is well in excess of $2 a gallon. And another reason, they just flat out look better than what you have at a traditional traffic signal. Like the roundabout behind me. If you had a traditional traffic signal here, it would wildly change the feel of this particular area. It's beautiful. It just adds more green space. It's a little more natural looking than all the wires and artificial machines and just everything that comes along with traffic signals and all the poles. It's just a little bit unsightly. I know that's subjective, but it is a good reason for the city to put in roundabouts. People like to be in a location that looks nice. If it's just broken down or just super, super busy and honestly, a little bit ugly, people have a tendency to not really want to be there. So the more beautiful it is, the more put together, the more aesthetically pleasing, people tend to, at least a majority, want to be in those locations. Now some of the money spent on Hazeldale in particular, 116th Street, 126th Street, and 131st Street, they actually have artwork in there, and I think it looks pretty cool. And of course, money had to be spent on putting those in, but they're aesthetically pleasing. They're at least cool looking. A lot of people don't like them, but a majority of people do like them. And it just jazzes up the intersection a little bit. It's local art, and people tend to enjoy having art in the places that they live. There's also a higher purpose for landscaping and artwork in a roundabout. In most cases in a roundabout, it's best if you can't really see all the way across to what's coming at you. It forces you to look to the left where you should be looking in a roundabout. So you look to the left, if nobody's coming, you know you can enter the roundabout. You're not distracted by people entering the roundabout on the opposite side. So if you have trees, like in this roundabout behind me right here, blocking your view, that's actually okay. It's a heck of a lot safer than might be if it was just completely blank. So a much higher purpose for it in there. Next reason is that roundabouts are just flat out more reliable than traffic signal. Roundabouts just don't fail. I mean, when do you remember the last time a roundabout failing? Now, it's pretty hard for that to happen, but everybody knows of a traffic signal failing, especially after maybe a major storm where the power goes out. The signals could also go out. Signals can go out on a perfectly sunny, beautiful day like today for whatever reason, and they can have flashing red lights or flashing yellow lights, and regardless, nobody really knows what the heck to do whenever you get up to a traffic signal that's broken. Even if it's flashing red, we all know we're supposed to stop, but it's hard to decide. We've got that stop, go, of not knowing exactly what everybody on the sides is gonna do. So, a lot more reliable. They're never going to fail, even in a storm, power surge, power outage, whatever it may be, they're always going to work. That brings us to the bonus reason and property value. Property value is such a subjective thing. I mean, we of course use data and numbers and all kinds of analytics to try to place a value on a property. And we do that to try to get a feel for where a property really should be priced. But ultimately, property value is a bit of a subjective thing. When a home sells, the actual value of that property is whatever the buyer and seller agree on. That's the true value, the market value for it. So things that pump up market value are those gotta have it features, or features that just at least don't take away from people wanting to be in that location. So roundabouts, they're one of those ancillary items that might help to stabilize property value or potentially increase it, I guess. But in most cases, it's just stabilizing it. Like this particular roundabout right here. And this one has mature trees, a lot of green space. It's absolutely beautiful. If you could imagine this being an actual traffic signaled intersection and then the homes that we can see nearby, I don't think that their value would be nearly as good. Traffic would be jammed up in this intersection a lot more. There'd be more noise, be more cars idling. There'd be honking, just generally a lot busier feeling than what it feels like right now. It feels a lot more peaceful having it built this particular way. So if you have questions about roundabouts, I am not your roundabout expert. I just know a few things about them. But if you have questions about Carmel, you have questions about Indianapolis, Fishers, or even Greenwood or Avon, any of the surrounding communities of Indianapolis, but including Indianapolis itself, and you're moving to or within any of those areas, feel free to give me a call, shoot me a text, send me an email. I'm happy to answer any kind of question that you might have or help you with your move.